Hello students, once again welcome back to Evershine Coaching Center. I am Faisal Shah here. So my dear students, today we are going to study science passing package. Is this clear? Now we are going to study the subject science. We are going to study the subject science. So this is your science passing package. Science passing package. Okay, without wasting much time, I'll just enter into the chapter. Okay, now the very first important thing, as you all know it, the heart of science to clear the paper is diagrams. Okay, the first topic is what? Diagrams. We used to believe that we may expect minimum 12 marks from diagrams. How many marks you learn? 12 marks. We believe as minimum 12, maximum it could be 14 or 16 also. It depends. Okay. Now, one thing you need to ensure, very importantly, I am saying this, in the diagrams, suppose we draw some XYZ diagram. Before the years, you might have seen option A something XYZ you mark, ABC you label. Something they used to say, we say this is XYZ and this is ABC. We used to mark this type of things. But now the trend has got changed. You may get even this also. I am not saying that it's not going to be asked. Sometimes this XYZ, instead of that, they may ask you the longest part, the largest part. It means they may give you the respective function of that, okay, uses of that, or sometimes advantages of that. No, you should identify some function they have given. You should identify which part function is this. Is this clear? Did you understood? What did I say? Very good. Liver. They may give the function of liver and they may ask you to label liver. Male part of flower, they will ask you to mark. Male part of flower, female part of flower, you need to mark. Did you understood? Understood? Very good. It means that you may not get direct option. They will give you the function of that. So you need to understand this very importantly. Is this clear, students? Very good. Now you all know this. Again, I'm just highlighting the part, highlighting the topics. In the diagram section, we have electrolysis of water, correct? Next, reaction of zinc granules with dilute sulfuric acid and testing hydrogen gas by burning. We also call that as pop test. Next, acid solution conduct electricity. Acid solution conducts electricity. Next, action of steam on metal. Next, testing the conductivity of salt solution. Next, electrolytic refining of copper. Then next, stomata, means stomatal pore, opening and closing of stomatal pore. Next, your lateral section of flower. Next, germination of pollen grain. And next, human elementary canal. And next, section of human heart, section of human heart. Next, excretory system. Excretory system in human beings, human heart, excretory system in human beings, structure of nephron. Next, human brain. Next, structure of neuron. Next, your simple circuit diagram. Are you getting, students? And next, Ohm's law circuit. Next, resistors are connected in series and parallel. And next, circuit symbols. And then next, magnetic field around a straight carrying conductor. Magnetic field around a straight carrying conductor. Electric motor. Next, biogas plant. Next, recombination of spectrum of white light. Next, ray diagrams of convex lens. And then next, ray diagrams of concave lens. Next, defects of eye. I'm going to write here the next part. Defects of eye. Next, recombination of spectrum of white light. I think we have done that. Recombination of spectrum of white light. We have done here in the spectrum. And next, electric generator. The next is electric generator. Next, we'll discuss. But initially, you need to remember these are the things what we have. Is this clear, students? So these are the diagram section. Very, 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 very important. I want you, all of you, need to draw and remember the namings of these all diagrams. Okay? And now, one thing I want to tell you people in this, what is that means, observe your students, especially for biology diagrams, which are the diagrams we have got, please try to make the table, draw the table, in that write the names of the parts, especially I am saying with respect to biology diagrams, please remember this carefully. Try to remember the name of the part. Okay, and remember the function of that part. Sometimes uses of that part. Is this clear? Sometimes defect. What is the defect of that part? And remedial measure, how to cure the disease. Is this clear? So you need to create this table according to your textbook, according to the given question, according to the given figure. What you are supposed to do is remember that part and remember the function of that, remember the uses of that. Okay, because most probably, okay, and make sure that if you know the other name of that, other name means the same name can be called in another way. If you can see, try to glance it. So it will give you very good marks. Is this clear? I am concerned with only biology, I am saying. Especially even physics and chemistry also you can do it. But you have to give a little bit more preference for biology. So whichever the biology diagrams you can see, make sure that you should draw this kind of table, create the chart in front of you. Because before the day of the exam, you can't study the entire book. If you can make the some topics, if you create a table contents, so it will be very much helpful for you to remember. We cannot study everything. Is this clear? That is the reason before the time, you should have the handful notes, not a large notes, not all your study materials, notes, textbooks, everything. No, you should have the simple handful material. That's it. You need to create that material before the day of exam. It has to be with you so that even early morning also you can easily glance it. Is this clear? Now, I just want to tell you some important points. Okay, diagrams 12 marks. Let me assume diagrams we have got 12 marks. But what is our passing mark? 28. But how much we have got? 12. So now for the next marks, what we can do? Very simple, students. What you are supposed to do is, I'm giving the assignment to you. What you should do is, I hope you know hydrocarbons. Correct? Carbon and its compounds. Is this clear? Now, we have two groups, saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. One section. The first section is saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Is this clear? Now, in saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons, we subclassify them into alkenes and alkynes. Please remember, this question is very, very, very important. Alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Now, what you should do in this? Minimum, first five. So, which are the first five? Meet. Which are the first five? This is number one. This is number two. This is number three. This is number four. And this is number five. First is meet. This is alkane, this is alkenes, and this is alkynes. Okay. First is meet. Second is eat. Third is probe. Fourth is butte. Fifth is pent. Minimum at least five. Okay. Meet, eat, probe, butte, pent. If any word, if it is ending with ane, that is alkane. If it is ending with ene, then it is alkene. If it is ending with yne, then it is alkyne. Okay? Meth. Add ane, methane. Eth. Add ane, ethane. Probe. Add ane, propane. Butte. Add ane, butane. Pent. Add ane, pentane. But we don't get methane. We don't have methane. We don't have methane, only methane is there. Next, in alkene group, the first member in one exam, this question has appeared. Who is the first member of alkene group? Methane. Who is the first member of alkene group? Ethene. Who is the first member of alkyne group? That is ethyne. Remember this very important question. Who is the first member of alkane? Who is the first member of alkene? And who is the first member of alkyne? They may ask you this question. You should not forget this. Okay. Same thing. Propene, butene, pentene. Propyne, butyne, pentyne. Now, to remember these values, that is meet, eat, probe, butte, pent. So what is the logic? Simple. Mitha, eating. Mitha means meet. Eating means eat. Pani Ping, Pro PP, Pani Ping, Mitha eating, Pani Ping, Bite Ko, means Butte. Panch Angliyan Se, Panch, five fingers means this, five fingers, five means pen, simple. Mitha eating, Pani Ping, Bite Ko, Panch Angliyan Se. In our Islamic, we used to say it is Sunnat, correct? So here also we are following the same thing. That's it, nothing else. Just we remember, okay? Now what you are supposed to do is, for mitha eating, pani peeing, bite ko panch angliyan se, means pet. In this, what you should know, that is very importantly, you need to remember these all compounds. These all can you see, methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, ethene, propane, butane, pentene, ethine, propine, butine, pentine. You need to remember their structural formula. You need to remember their structural formula and molecular formula. Remember this, students, very important. You need to remember the structural formula and molecular formula of these all compounds. Any doubts? Is this clear? So this question is important as per your passing package. Okay. And then we have another type of hydrocarbons. Which are those? We have number one, alicyclic hydrocarbons and aromatic hydrocarbons. And then isomers. Done? Good. Now come back to alicyclic hydrocarbon. Which is alicyclic hydrocarbon? If any word, if it starts from cyclo, then it is alicyclic. The structure is round shape, cyclic. Okay, it is in the shape of round. Cyclo. Okay, cyclopentane, cyclohexane. Okay, again, these also you need to draw molecular formula and structural formula. Cyclopentane and cyclohexane. Coming back to aromatic hydrocarbons, which are the aromatic hydrocarbons? That is benzene. Very important, children. Benzene here, cyclohexane is also very important. Almost everything is very important. Okay, benzene. Next is toluene. Next is naphthalene. Is this clear, students? Again, we need to draw the molecular formula and structural formula of these compounds also. Next, you can write the isomers of butane, isomers of pentane. Okay, again, those molecular and structural formulas also you need to draw, etc. Okay, so this is regarding molecular formula and structural formula. Now, after this, what we can do? What we need to study? Okay, let's see. After this, the important concept here is, after this part, your dot structures. That is dot structures. Okay, like example, formation of sodium chloride, you can see the dot structure is there. Formation of magnesium chloride, you can see dot structure is there. For like carbon dioxide, sulfur, potassium, are you getting H2S? So we have got many dot structures, okay? You can open metals and non-metals chapter, even in that also you get dot structures and carbon and its compounds, you can study the dot structures. This is one topic. Is this clear, students? Next, one more topic what you can study here in terms of passing package, okay? After dot structures, we can also learn functional group. Very important, children, and you can study about homologous series also. Homologous series. Okay, out of these two parts, definitely you can expect one question. Out of these parts, minimum one question you can expect in your exam. You should not forget, again, functional group you need to study. It's there in your textbook. Direct table you need to remember. Which are aldehydes, okay, ketone group, carboxylic acids, okay. So these all functional groups you need to remember and homologous series. Okay. Next, after this, the important part, okay, almost we have done. around 12 marks we have got from this. Another 4 marks, now the topics whatever we have discussed, minimum. Maximum you may get more than this also. But always we try to think minimum. So later we get maximum. First only we should not think maximum. That's the reason. Okay. Anyways, so these are the topics you want to go through it in the beginning. Any doubts? Good. Now, let me start important things. Then means minimum these things must and should you have to practice. Must and should you should know this. That is what my question. Okay. So remember. Now, I'll come back with step by step. I want you have to prepare the notes for this and start studying. It's not like notes means copy paste work. No, notes it has to be made in your mind now. That's it. Just make these all questions, write every day 10 questions, 15 questions, 20 questions, like first part. Next, second part, you can go with chapter wise revision. Okay, in my next video, I will tell you the program of work, how you can do, how you can manage in a day, how you can distribute the number of hours for all the subjects, how you can start preparing. But make sure that April 15th is your deadline date to complete the revision, because already we have started the classes from yesterday. Right? From yesterday we have started up the classes. Is this clear? So from now here onwards, each and every day you need to utilize to sit and practice. Okay, now I am coming back to the main concept of today's session. After your diagrams and like how we had theorems and constructions part, here also we had already theorems and constructions. Okay, so all those things has been done. There is no theorems here. Example I am saying, like your diagrams and some constructions like drawings and other type of drawings. No, the very importantly you need to focus here on one thing. What it is means, okay, the important question number one, your loss of reflection and refraction. You need to know this, students. Laws of reflection and refraction. Is this clear? Very important. You should remember what are the laws of reflection and what are the laws of refraction. In refraction, we have one more law, sub-law, that is called as Snell's law. Particularly, they will ask you like this itself. Remember, state Snell's law. Like that itself, they will ask you the question. You should remember that. Okay? Good. Next is, see, now I am giving the easiest topic, so anyone can study that, anyone can study. I am giving such type of topics here, okay. Next is, uses of mirror and lenses. You should learn what are the uses of mirror and what are the uses of lenses, okay. Your concave, convex, these things, you need to know those uses. Sometimes they will give you the practical application. Okay, so this glass is used where? Spectacles is been used where? In car, this glass is used where? Rear view glass. Okay, this glass is used where? Like such type of questions could be asked. Okay, but you should have the subject knowledge. That is important. Mug-upping is not a option. Okay, remembering the topic and understanding the concept is very important here. Done? Good. After that, we have another formula that is called as lens formula and mirror formula. Please study that lens formula and mirror formula, so that these formulas will be helpful for us while solving the problems. That is the reason. And you know very well, as I have said you, defects of vision, correct? Which are the defects of vision? We have myopia, correct? Hypermetropia, okay? Now here, please remember, what is the remedy for that? What is the remedial measure? Remedy, how to correct the disease? Okay, and you should draw the ray diagram for that. So remember, myopia and hypermetropia. This is very, very important question, because even in last year, this question has appeared. That is the reason I'm saying, don't forget this question. Because this question has maximum values. It may be asked for 1 mark, 2 mark or 3 mark also. There is a reason. If you get 3 mark, it's a jackpot for you. Okay, you should define what is myopia and what is the actual ray diagram and what is the correction. So means the disease, due to the disease, how it looks. Know what is the correction and what is the final result. Okay, you need to draw the ray diagram and you have to tell the correction. Is this clear? And you have to define also. Now in this, one more disease we have in the eye, which is this presbyopia. Presbyopia, cataract. You should know, even you should know about these diseases also. Myopia, hypermetropia is the ray diagram, but for here there is no ray diagram. You don't need to think so much. We have, but still remember what is a presbyopia and how to how to rectify the disease. Presbyopia, cataract and night blindness. What do you mean by night blindness? You can study about that part. Okay, next is Ohm's law. Next is Ohm's law. You can define what is Ohm's law. And you can study about ocean thermal energy. You can also study about ocean thermal energy. Okay, ocean thermal energy is there. And next is wind energy is there. Okay, tidal energy is there. Okay, geothermal energy is there. Geothermal energy is there. Okay, so these are the different types of energy which we have got. Solar energy is there. Solar energy. Okay, so ocean thermal energy, wind energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy, solar energy. About these all energies, what you can do is you can study the uses. You can study their uses, advantages and disadvantages. Yes, students. So, ocean thermal energy, wind energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy, solar energy. I want you have to go with these all topics, advantages and as well their disadvantages. Okay. Okay. And the next topic here. What you can study. Okay. That is how to conserve our fossil fuels. Conservation of fossil fuels. So even you can study the topic related to how to conserve our fossil fuels. Means what is the alternate fuel? Okay, alternate source of energy. What is the alternate fuel? If you want to conserve the fossil fuels. So what you are going to do to conserve the fossil fuels? And here some definitions are there, children. Definitions are there. You need to study those definitions. Okay. Which are those definitions? That is power of accommodation. Power of accommodation. Electric power. And electric potential charge. What is charge? Okay, what is power of accommodation? What is electric power? Write the SI unit of it. What is electric potential? Write the SI unit of it. What is charge? Write the SI unit of it. SI unit of heat. Okay, and next, what is heating effect of electric current? Heating effect of electric current. And what is the mathematical formula of that? Formula you should remember. What is the mathematical formula of heating effect of electric current? Is this clear? And next, define power. What is power? And SI unit of power. So these definitions you need to go through, children. Okay. And after that, certain differences are there, children. You need to go with those differences also. So which are those differences? That is voltmeter, differences between voltmeter and ammeter. Voltmeter and ammeter. And your dynamo and motor. Okay, your motor and generator, motor and generator. Are you getting, children? So like that you can go with differences also. And next is, you need to remember one more important law, that is Faraday's law. Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. Next is Fleming's rule. Fleming's right hand rule and left hand rule. Right hand rule and right hand rule. Fleming's right hand rule and left hand rule. Okay, Fleming's right hand rule and Fleming's left hand rule. And next is Maxwell's rule. Maxwell's rule. You can study that questions. Okay, and here one more important question, children, that is properties of magnetic field. Properties of magnetic field. Okay, and very important question, children. What is solenoid and uses of solenoid, that is advantages of solenoid. It's very important question, should not forget. And what is solenoid? What is electromagnetic induction? What is electromagnetic induction? And later one diagram we have, that is human eye. Based on human eye also, you can get the part, you have got the parts in human eye. They may ask you to write the functions of the following parts. Like example, cornea. So what is the function of cornea? What is the function of lens? What is the function of iris? What is the function of pupil? What is the function of retina? Okay. And remember, they may give you the diagram. Okay. And they may ask you to identify which part is this. Is diagram based question. They'll give the figure. They themselves will give the diagram. And they may ask you to identify which part will come here. Okay. And here we have one part that is called as fovea. Okay. Fovea. That is called as yellow spot. Remember this name. Yellow spot. Fovea. Okay. Is this clear, students? Okay. Next, we discuss one more important topic here, that is balancing the chemical reactions. Balancing the equations. They may give you the equation, you need to balance. Or they will not give you the equation, they will give you in the sentence formation. Example, what happens when magnesium reacts with oxygen? What happens when ferrous sulfate reacts with copper? Got it? So like that, definitions also they may give you. So you need to remember. Then also you have to convert that into its respective formula. Then you have to balance the equation. Sometimes they will give you the direct values and just you have to balance it. Sometimes they may give you in indirect form. So remember how to balance the chemical equations. Okay? To balance the chemical equations, you can use the chapter to balance the chemical equation. You can go with the chapter Chemical Equation and Reaction. You can take Chemical Reactions and Equations. You can take the chapter Chemical Reaction and Equations, Acid Bases and Salts, Metals and Non-Metals, Metals and Non-Metals. At least you can try with these chapters how to balance the chemical reaction. You take one chemical from that and you can balance the reaction. And here I just want to mention one more important thing, that is example in your first chapter, that is chemical reactions and equations. Okay, some chemical is there which is called as X. When it reacts with Y, we get one product, correct? Yes, students. So X plus Y, it reacts, some product is going to obtain. Okay, this is the reactant part. So this one is our reactant part and this is our product part, correct? Okay, so we have reactant as well as the product. Everyone knows if this both reacts, what is going to come. Yes, we know the product, but in exam they may not ask you the product. What they will do, they will ask you the properties of the product, like which color gas is obtained, what is the color of the gas, what is the color of the gas. Okay, they may ask you some properties with respect to that. Be careful. Did you understood? Sometimes they will give the use of that. They will give the uses of that product. They may ask you to write the use of the product. It means first you should know what is the product, then you can have to write the use. Directly they are writing this reacts with this, one product is going to obtain. Okay, now what he has done? He has not given the product. He is not asking you to write the product also. He is asking you to write the use of that. So first you should know the product and you should know some properties. It's not going to be asked out of your textbook, okay? From your textbook itself, while you're reading your textbook, please read. Please read once. What is the color? What is the use of that? Understood? Whether in which form it is, powder form or what's which form. Did you understood? Some properties will be given of that product. Little bit information will be given about that product. Understood? So please, you have to go with that type of questions also. While you're studying, you have to study even that also. Got it? Good. And next is, we have got different types of chemical reactions in your first chapter, right? Types of chemical reactions. Types of chemical reactions. In types of chemical reactions, what they are going to do for you, we have different types of reactions, right? Which are the different types of reactions? Combination reaction. Correct? Decomposition reaction, displacement reaction. Okay, now what you can do is remember the definition. What is combination reaction? And example of that. But chances are less. What chances? Of asking the question like what is combination reaction, chances are less. Then what question will be asked? But you should know the reaction means definition also, but chances are less. What they will do, they will give one example like this. Some name will be given, not AB, some name will be given. Now they will ask you to identify which is this reaction. They may give you like this: AB plus C will becomes AC plus B. Are you getting children? So we step out. This is an example for the dash reaction. So you should be careful even in this type of questions also. They will give example, you should identify which reaction is that. Are you getting children? So you have to remember types of chemical reaction and their examples. Okay. And now, we go with question number 18. Question number 18. Now, one more question is there in your first chapter, which is very important. That is, what is oxidation reaction and what is reduction reaction? Okay, gaining of oxygen, losing of hydrogen. Gaining of hydrogen, losing of oxygen. So they may ask you what is oxidation reaction and what is reduction reaction, as well their examples. Now the question here again repeats. Chances are less. They may ask you what is oxidation, what is reduction. Here we have two types of questions. They will give you one reaction. Now you should identify. You should identify who is going to oxidize and who is going to reduce. You should identify that. Understood? Who is oxidized and who is reduced? You should identify. First question. Second question. They'll give an example. They will ask you, identify which reaction is this. Whether it is oxidation reaction or it is reduction reaction, you should identify. Understood? In this, which reaction has happened? In this, which reaction has happened? You should identify. whether it, I mean, the product is oxidized or it has reduced. Who is oxidized and who is reduced? And who is the reducing agent? Who is the reducing agent in this? That also is very important. You should know who is the reducing agent. Done? So you need to learn the questions based on the topic also. Oxidation and reduction. And next, we have got rancidity. One more important topic. Rancidity. So what is rancidity? Okay. But here, maximum, they will ask you, give reason questions. Maximum, they will ask you, give reason type of questions from the topic rancidity. You need to remember that. And you should know what are the products. We have one chemical reaction, children, about lead nitrate. That is very, very, very important chemical reaction. Please focus on this. Focus on this topic, lead nitrate. Okay. And what are the proper products is obtained? Okay. When lead nitrate is reacted with some chemical, so what is the product is obtained? You can study in your textbook. So that import, that is what are the products of lead nitrate. That lead nitrate chemical reaction itself is very important. So in my next video, I'll be going to explain about those topics. Like separately, I will take balancing the chemical reactions equation, how to balance the reactions, and I will give you the questions also related to that. You can sit and practice. And you should know some one important topic, that is preparation. This question may carries high marks, means more marks. How to prepare this salt? Salts. Preparation of certain salts. So which are the salts? Okay, you should know the procedure. Okay, that is our sodium hydroxide. Next is bleaching powder. Then next is washing soda, and then plaster of Paris, and next is baking soda, and the next one is baking soda. So you should know the preparation of this salts, how to prepare this. And one more table you can draw after this. You can draw one more table. In that, what you can do is write the names of these salts. Okay, write their uses next to that one. You can create the table like this and write their formula also. Write the respective formula. Okay, so bleaching powder, what is the uses of bleaching powder and what is the formula of bleaching powder? Plaster of Paris, washing soda, baking soda. Okay, so these things you can just go with that. And one more important option is there. They may not ask you that, preparation, but you should know the formula of that. What is that? That is gypsum. Gypsum. Okay, so you should know the difference between gypsum and plaster of Paris. One more question you can expect definitely from this topic, plaster of Paris and gypsum. Very, very, very important topic, that one. So you should not forget the preparation of the salts, uses and respective formulas of that. Any doubts, children? I hope you are understanding this. Children, one thing I just want to tell you all, please don't watch it, then you have to copy the notes of this. Okay, while I'm explaining, same time, like you need to feel this is your classroom. You are inside the classroom, your teacher is dictating, your teacher is explaining, and she is asking you to copy down the notes. Okay, if you first you listen, then you pause, stop, then write, again you play. No, you should not do that. So simultaneously, you should create the habit, you need to listen as well as you need to copy down that. Is this clear? So that you can save more time. Next is our question number 21, correct? No, last question is what? I think question number 20, right? Yes, the last question was question number 20. Now we are coming back to question number 21. just a minute. Children, are you getting these questions? Now I want you need to study this. In this, whatever you get doubt, please comment me. Okay, or you can drop the message to me. I'll try to take care of that part. And I will make one more video. And I'm going to explain you the topic. Is this clear? I'm giving you the topic because already I have done this. It's not the first day you're listening this chapter or listening this concept. That's the reason I'm just highlighting what are the things you need to study. Very important. Nothing else. Okay? And after that, you should know the definition. You should also know the definition of water of crystallization. Water of crystallization. Okay? And after water of crystallization, what is neutralization reaction? What is neutralization reaction? What is precipitation reaction? What is substitution reaction? Children, are you getting this? Questions? Yes. What is substitution reaction? So these definitions also you should know. And after that, very important question, children, this one. Okay, you should write the properties of ionic compounds. Properties of ionic compounds. You need to behead that answer. You need to understand and behead the answer. Okay. And you should also know what are amphoteric oxides. Even that is also an important question. What are amphoteric oxides? You should know that definition also. And after that, you should know the differences between ethanol and ethanol. It's very important question, children. Don't forget and don't miss. Very important question. Differences between ethanol and ethanol. And you should write their chemical properties. You should write their chemical properties of this both. And you should write the uses of this both. Very important question. Definitely you can expect this question, children. The differences between ethanol and ethanol, and write the chemical properties of this both, and write the uses also of this both. Okay, done, good. And after that, I told you in the previous concepts like electron dot structure. So even that electron dot structure comes to your hydrocarbons also, like your methane, ethane, ethene. Okay, so your dot structures, again I'm just reminding you people, okay, you need to remember these structures, children. Okay, like carbon dioxide, your methane, ethane, ethene, are you getting ethine? Okay, you need to draw the dot structures of this also, your hydrogen, H2S, children, are you understanding? Okay. So like this, we have got dot structures. You need to study that. And functional group and its structures, I have said you. And next one is, you need to know definitions. Definitions of whom? That is, Dobernier law, state. State, Dobernier, law of triacs. Next, Newland, law of octaves. Next, Mendeleev's law, and next is Moseley's law. That is nothing but modern periodic table. You should know, and as well as from this all, you should know their advantages and disadvantages. But particularly of this, you should know the advantages. Very important question. Very important question. So you should not forget that. Is this clear? So you should know the statements of state, Dobernier law of triads, Newland law of octaves, Mendeleev's law, and Moseley's law. And advantages and disadvantages of Dobernier, Newland, and Mendeleev. But in modern, advantages of modern periodic table. And you may get some questions like why agitation is required to clean the clocks? Why agitation why agitation is required to clean the cloths. Why agitation is required to clean the cloths. Okay, and after that one more thing, what is isomerism? That is also important question. What is isomerism? Okay, what is atomic size? What is atomic size? Okay, what is octet structure? What is octet structure? Children, are you understanding? Okay, and here one more question can be asked for you. Why noble gases are considered as zero group? They are called as zero group elements. Why? In which group they belongs to? 18th group of the periodic table. And why all noble gases are inert gases, but all inert gases are not noble gases? Even that is also important question. Okay, you can study that. And you should know the differences between calcination and roasting. Okay, and one more definition. What is homologous series? Okay, and you should differentiate between calcination and roasting, and next combustion and oxidation. Combustion and oxidation. Okay, and oxidation and reduction reaction, both together we call as redox reaction. Okay, both together we call them as redox reaction. Okay, you can study that. And after that, you should differentiate between esterification and saponification. Esterification and saponification. You can study even this type of questions also. And very importantly, you should know the trends of modern periodic table. Then what you can do, children, here in trends of modern periodic table, atomic size. What happens along a period? Down a group. Ionization energy. What happens along a period? Down a group. Okay. And after that, your metallic nature. What happens along a period? Down a group. And one more definition was there. What are metalloids? And give their examples. So these are the questions, children. Okay. And next, coming back to question number 33, very, very, very important question, children. Various pathways, that is flow chart of your glucose. Okay. It's there your diagram. It's there one diagram. Okay. Like this. Various pathways of glucose. Okay. Your flow chart of glucose. It's very important question. Very, 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 very important question. You should remember what is fermentation, and you should explain the various pathways of glucose pathway. That flow chart you should draw the flow chart, and you have to describe that. That's it, nothing else. Okay, after that you should know how the digestion will happen in small intestine. How the digestion will take place in small intestine. And you should know the difference between valves and septum. Valves and septum. And one more I have difference forgotten from your physics part. Rods and cones. Very important question. Rods and cones. Okay, valves and septum differences. Rods and cones differences. Blood and lymph differences. Okay. Blood and lymph, bone and cartilage, bone, cartilage. You should know this type of differences. It's very basic children. Okay? And after that, you should know the pathway of, like how we have done the pathway of glucose. Similarly, pathway of reflex action also you should do. Pathway of reflex action. I think in a textbook they have given, a person is holding a hot object, okay? So they will ask you which is the motor neurons, okay? So how it's the input and how it is the output, how output and input is going on. So which nerves are helping for input and which nerves are taking back the information. So you should describe that part also. Sometimes they'll give you the figure. From the figure, they may ask you some kind of hidden part. So you should know that question also. So pathway of reflex action. And after that, very, very, very important, you should know what are plant hormones. So which are the plant hormones? And please remember their functions. Very, very, very important question. I told you. So you should know which are the plant hormones and what are their functions. Means uses. So where exactly they are going to be used. Okay. Plant hormones and functions. You can just draw the table for that. It will be easy to you to remember. Similarly, even animal hormones also. One question definitely you will get from this chapter. One question definitely you will get. Seriously. Maybe from your plant hormone or animal hormone. Very important topic, children. These both are very important topic. And one more question. What is menstruation? Why menstruation occurs? Why menstruation occurs? Why menstruation occurs? They may ask you this question. And after that, what are the methods? Which are the methods is being used, okay? Which are the methods which been used to prevent pregnancy? That is the methods of contraception. Methods of contraception. Is this clear? So you should know their different methods. So which are the different methods which we are going to use for contraception? And very, 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 very important question, children. This one. Differentiate between acquired trait and inherited trait. Acquired trait and inherited trait. Very important question. You should not miss this question. Okay. And you need to define speciation. You need to define what is speciation. Based on speciation, you can expect some kind of indirect question also. You can expect some indirect question also. But you should have the subject knowledge. That's it. That's enough. And you need to know the differences between very, very, very important questions. Even this and this. Okay? Differentiate between analogous and homologous. Analogous and homologous organs. Analogous and homologous organ. And you should know what are fossils. What are fossils? How can we determine the age of fossils? How can we determine the age of fossils? It's very important question, even this. And you should define what do you mean by 10% rule. What do you mean by 10% rule? Here you may get diagram based question. Diagram based question can be asked, plus any problem can be asked. From here to here this much, from here to here this much, what will be here? Okay, here is some 1 lakh joules. Okay, here is somewhere around 1 lakh joules. So what is at this stage? Like that you need to apply 10% rule over there. So you may get either diagram based question or some small numerical problem could be asked here based on 10% rule. And you should know what is ozone layer depletion. What do you mean by ozone layer depletion? Next, causes. Next, what are the effects due to ozone layer depletion, and how can you prevent it? Remedy, preventive measures. How can you prevent the disc ozone layer depletion? Okay, And after that, this one, after ozone, what is ozone layer? If possible, you try to explain how ozone layer depletion takes place. Okay? And what are the causes? Why ozone? What? Because of what ozone layer depletion is going to take place? And because of that, how it is affecting our atmosphere? They may ask you effects. Particularly, they may ask you the question: effects of ozone layer depletion of environment on ecosystem. Understood? They will ask you the questions particular field also. With respect to that field, how ozone layer depletion is going to be getting affected. Okay? Is this clear? So you can remember. And what are greenhouse gases? In the same topic about greenhouse effect. Greenhouse effect. So which are the gases are responsible for that greenhouse effect? And what is one more question is there? Global warming. So you can remember global warming and what are the effects? What are the effects due to global warming? Okay, this question. And after that, advantages. So what are the advantages of using cloth bag? What are the advantages of using cloth bag over plastic bag? They may ask you this question. Because nowadays, you know very well, plastic bags are banned. Why? They may ask you this question. Why plastic bags are banned? Why we are not using plastic bag? Why government has made a restriction that made a rule that plastic bag should not be used? Why? Give reason. Like such type of questions could be asked. In indirect form also the question can be asked. So you should remember. Okay? Advantages of cloth bag over plastic bag. And you should know which are our 5 R's. Very, very, very important question. Even this also important question. 5 R's. Okay? Is this clear? And next, they may ask you the question based on dams. Very important, children. Very important question you can expect here. Dams. So why, what are the advantages of constructing a dam? And what are the disadvantages of constructing a dam? They may ask you both the things simultaneously. Advantages as well as disadvantages. Advantages of constructing a dam and disadvantages of constructing a dam. Okay? Okay. How the peoples are helpful because of dam and how the peoples are getting affected due to the dam. Okay, you should know that. Construction of dam, due to the construction of dam. And you should know the differences between biodegradable and non-biodegradable substances. You should know the difference between biodegradable and non-biodegradable substances. And you should define here. What define? Your vegetative propagation. Okay. And after that vegetative propagation, you should define. Okay. Vegetative propagation. And next, fragmentation. Budding, spore formation. And as well, you can expect the diagram based question also here. So which is the correct order, they can ask you. Okay, like that kind of questions. They may give you the answer, they will ask you the question. Which type of propagation, which type of formation is this? Okay? So you should know those things. And I told you the one more important thing is functions. So remember the functions of parts of the brain and functions of the parts of alimentary canal. Alimentary canal functions, brain functions, excretory system functions, okay, neuron functions, nephron functions. So you can study the diagram which has been given to you, in that namings has been given, take those namings, write their functions. Okay, and you can write a note on limp. You can write the note on limb, okay, and you can write a note on how the nutrition is going to take place in amoeba. Nutrition in amoeba, you need to write a short note, okay. And next is differences between autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. What is autotrophic nutrition and what is heterotrophic nutrition? And after that, in your respiratory system also an important difference is there. Transpiration, 1 minute, let me to complete this. Transpiration and translocation. Transpiration and translocation. And 1 minute, I'll let you know. One more important question is there. I'm just taking the simple questions here, Charles. Okay. Aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Okay. Aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. And again, differences between monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. Dihybrid, monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. And here you may get any question which belongs to long marks also. You need to draw the checkerboard. You need to explain dihybrid cross. You need to explain monohybrid cross kind of questions. With their genotopic ratio and phenotopic ratios also. Okay. And here one more question could be asked for you like this. How do you determine the sex of the child? How do you determine the sex of the child? That is one. The same question can be asked like this. The sex of the child is determined what they inherit from their father. What they inherit from their father and not from the mother. Justify. Same tip. One more question. You can expect to determine the sex of the child, why father is so important. To determine the sex of the child, why father is very important. Okay. That type of question also can be appeared. Are you getting, children? Is this clear? Very good. And apart from that, one more question can expect here. What is rooftop gardening? Water harvesting system. You just make what is corrosion? What is corrosion and causes of corrosion? Preventive measures of corrosion. What is rooftop gardening? Okay. And what is water harvesting system? Water harvesting. Based on this topic, little bit information also you need to collect, not only definitions. Okay. What is water harvesting? Rooftop gardening, understood. And how can you conserve your forest? Conservation of forest, I think I have given, but once again I'm just giving. How can you conserve our forest? What are the ways to conserve the forest? And why do we want to manage our natural resources? What is the reason? Okay. And after that, you need to explain about biogas plant. Okay, that question, what is the source of energy? And here you can study one question is definitely you will get from this. One definite question you can expect, atmospheric refraction. You can study about atmospheric refraction. In that you'll be getting other questions like about the twinkling of stars, sunlight, early sunrise, delay sunset kind of things, and about your scattering of light. Okay, scattering of light. So in scattering of light, the questions will be asked like Tyndall effect, why the sky color is blue. Okay, color of the sunrise and color of the sunset. So this type of questions you can expect from that. And dispersion of white light through glass prism, that you can study through this. Is this clear? Okay. And apart from that, numericals are there. Definitely I'll be going to teach you all the numericals in separate video. So I think I have done much for you people. And so what is sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction, differences. Okay, differences between your sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Sexual and asexual reproduction. You can expect the question between fission and fusion. You should know the difference between fission and fusion. Okay. And what is the importance of variation? Why variation is so important? Okay. What is the importance of variation? You can expect that question also in fragmentation. Okay, in fragmentation, in fission reaction, they will give the diagram. They will ask you to arrange that in an order. Okay, write the correct order. Are you getting, children? So you may get that type of questions also. And you need to explain your chlor-alkali process. Chlor-alkali. And you should write their uses. And you should write their respective uses. Still, if anything is there, definitely I'll come back and I'm going to explain you even those things. But initially around 63 topics I have given here to remember. So study, children, definitely these questions, you should not buy these questions. First itself I'm saying you should understand the meaning, understand the concept, because the questions can be asked you in any of the format. Maybe it is direct or it is indirect. Understood. In these topics, if you are finding some doubts, you can ask me, as well as what I will be doing here. Okay, from every chapter wise, again I will be giving the page numbers kind of thing, and I will make separate videos chapter wise also, what you have to study from that chapter, in case if you want to score very good marks. First you have to go, this is compulsory, first you need to go with this. I think tissue culture is also there, I have forgotten. But still long answer questions are there, but I have not taken much here long answers. Short answers, so easily you people can remember and you can easily clear the paper. That is what my intention. You should clear the paper. Okay. So I have done much for you people. So please go through these all the topics. Take the notes, take your textbook, start practicing. Make the proper notes for this kind of thing. Start practicing, discuss with your friends in case if you belong to the same family or something, but maintain the distance. Please don't come outside, don't roam here and there, sit in one side, start and utilize this opportunity for your preparation. Okay, how much time you have got, that is your benefit actually. Okay, so please go ahead, do well, don't miss any of the topics, start studying right from now. Okay. So if you like my video, if you like my content, if you might like my explanation, so please, you can just share it, you can like it, you can share it to your other friends, and you can call your other friends also to come to this channel and access these videos in these days. Okay, don't miss any of the topics and please start practicing. Thank you. Best of luck.